Happy Republic Day to everyone. And since I got more subscribers and more views for my kitchen organization part 2 vlog, I thought of doing a continuation of it. So this is the part 3 vlog, more about how I organize my spices cabinet and everything. And I would like to give you more tips about how I arrange things in here. So let's have a look. In this vlog, I would like to give you some tips on how I arrange things here. And by using my son's old desk, how I, you know, organize everything here. So I'll show you in detail how I did this.
So this was my son's old study desk. So when we got a new one for him, he doesn't use this anymore. So what I thought is I'll make use of this desk in my kitchen. I made use of this by placing a mat here. So I'm going to start off by placing this two-tier stand here, and I'm going to arrange tea, sugar, coffee canisters. By placing it here. So in my every vlog, I always say that, you know, whatever you have at home, you can make use of the things. So now, since I made use of this desk, I could arrange all the things here. And I'm going to place these glass mugs here. Then for my son, he always likes to take chocolates. Like,
so I keep chocolates here for his easy access. And now next, below this stand, I'm going to keep this onion basket. And okay, now this is how I arranged it. Now this space, I'm going to use it to store containers where I've kept different types of rices. Now this is how I arranged this, and this is how I was using it all this time, by placing these containers of rices here. But now I made a slight change. So this is what I'm going to use now to place all the appliances here. So this is called a corner shelf, and as you can see, it's a three-tier stand. So I'm going to place it here. Okay. So one by one, I'm going to place all the appliances here. And to keep these hooks and these stainless beaters, I thought I'll just take a glass and I'll just store it in this manner. So now I saved a lot of space. I find this it's even for easy access. I kept all the appliances here. So this is the final look of the desk which I made use of. If you have different types of baking pans, baking tins, it takes a lot of space in your kitchen cabinet. So to arrange this, I got another technique. Even I don't have a lot of space in my kitchen shelf, so I thought of arranging it in a box, which is a plastic container. So I'll show you how I organized it, and I made use of the floor space to organize these things.
I'm going to organize this baking tins one by one.
There's a lot of space in this container. You can keep as many things you want. It's all related to baking. And this is the cake stand which I showed in one of my Diwali videos. Now still there's space left. See, now I was able to arrange all these baking pans here in this plastic container. Now below this desk, I'm making use of this floor space to keep this container here. I would like to talk about how I arrange my spices here on the countertop. You can see I used here a three-tier stand. So I just, you know, kept it in this manner so you can use it very easily. And you know, the spices won't get spoiled in case, you know, if there's water in your hands, so you don't need to go for a big canister, which I arranged it here. So for my easy access, I kept everything here, so within reach. So when it gets over, what I do is I just refill it, and the rest of the spices I keep it in the large container. So I refill it and I keep it here. Then the rest of the spice powder, chili powders, I keep it in this large container. As and when required, I just transfer it into the small canister, spice rack.
Next, I made use of the wall space to arrange my other different spices like oregano, paprika powder and everything. I thought I'll just make use of this wall space here. Then to keep cooking oil and everything, salt and everything, I bought this stand and I arranged it in this manner.
So next one, I'm going to hang this broomstick, because you know, most of the time it just falls down because it doesn't stay centrally. So I'm going to stick this. I bought this adhesive removable hooks, so this can hold up to 3.5 kg. So anyway, this is like, so just need to peel this off. So after sticking this hook onto the wall, you have to give it some time before hanging this broomstick. Okay, now I'm going to hang this. I'll show you how it stays in place now. See, so similar to this hook is another kind of hook, because I have to hang the small broomstick here. So
finally, these broomstick will stay in place, and now this looks much better than before.
Okay, another tip what I would like to share with you. What I use is, like, after washing all my utensils and dishes, I use the system of drying them by using this dish drying mat. I'm sure you all will be familiar with this. I use this because of the advantage of, like, after drying all the dishes, it can be hanged easily. It doesn't take a lot of space. Like, I've seen some people using baskets and, you know, like plastic containers for just drying the utensils. They just keep it in the baskets. But I feel after that usage, it takes a lot of space. So, but this one, you can just hang it, and you know, it's washable also, and it gets dry very fast. So I'll show you how I do it. Another organizing technique which I use, this is called as a plastic bag dispenser. Now all the shopper bags which we get, you know, instead of just keeping it here and there, just fold it, like, you know, just fold it in this manner, and you can just arrange it like this so that it looks neatly arranged and it stays in place. So, and whenever required, you can just pull it out from the middle and take it. And these are my favorite wall hanging, inspirational wall hangings. And this is a 360 view of my kitchen. I would like to show you. It's nothing else, everything what I mentioned here. And on the countertop, you can see these things what I arranged. So that's it for today's weekend vlog. Hope you all liked it. And thank you so much for all the new subscribers and for the lovely comments. So please do support me again and again, so I'll come up with more and new organizing ideas and vlog. And for the new viewers especially, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. And that's it for today's weekend vlog. Have a nice weekend, and that's it. Bye.